This will be probably faster than Sunday by a bit, but it's definitely overall slower than I like. Oh well, that's how it goes, right? So we got 3, 75, 90, so 45 encounters, give or take. About 5 ults plus this annex. Yeah, I'm thinking we probably don't need to buy anymore. Let's get our arc fires. Alright, sick. Hurry back. Alright, sorry about that. Runny nose. I feel like it's been happening a lot lately, but probably because we're getting some big temperature drops. It's not actually going into freezing yet, but it's been surprisingly aggressive. I know it's September and all, but still. I mean, so I guess it feels weird for it to drop by like 20 degrees Celsius from day to night. Where are we living in the desert? Okay, let's get. Have we seen us sneaking behind and snipe one of the griffins as usual? That's an interesting enemy formation. I know we're a little farther back than normal, but that got weird. That's very early max strength. I like it. Stupid Swordmaster. Teach you. Ugh, so much pavis. Yeah, the AI is landing a lot of lucky low percent hits for these runs. Rather, I guess, this particular run. Maybe on a very strange roll. Definitely blasting through these enemies, even though it moves like we're, or it feels like we're moving a little slowly still. A little surprised he went down so easily through Pavis. Empty hole for Morgan. Man, D4 really slowed down because for the longest time it was really leading the other stats for Robin. But now we've kind of swung back into the standard everything except for D4 and Rez max out. Bye, Yenfei. Bye, Yenfei. Okay, I guess we're just doing foraging now. Foraging in a slightly different set of or suite of tonics. Or rather, I guess, further enhanced. Probably the best way of describing it. Oof, Lucina didn't actually get to. I should have been watching that a little more closely. Didn't quite get to Paladin, so Morgan's defenses are gonna be a little bit lower. I guess at least as far as concrete defenses go. He should be a little more avoidy with a Pegasus backpack. I guess this means that Crom gets both Armor Slayers. have its all around, so I guess we're not gonna try to hammer them. It's a shame because they don't have counter. That doesn't look like he should have much for survival issues. The rest are all in Morgan's blind spot, so I guess we're just gonna leave it. This is definitely gonna mess with Lucina's sword proficiency. Yes. Try and stand in the corner and kill everyone. Hey, that takes care of Chrom's permission. Well, the rate things are going, it looks like he might end up getting to 11. Because Robin still needs to actually get to 15. Yeah, so many empty levels that can't really be helped. Almost there. I guess Lucina might end up at 11 too. I swap Lucina back to Lansen's here. At least make the most of it by getting her to B. Thank you. Well, definitely won't complain about Raz. Yep, there's 11 for Lucina. There we go. And another empty wall. Hooray! I didn't realize Morgan's axes were that far behind. Like, we definitely used Hellswath less than you fell, but I guess at some point I should figure out when I want to get more. I guess chapter 20 is pretty decent for it. We need to be fighting stuff at multiple ranges anyway. But I think for now we're just gonna do bow to finish cleaning this up because it's safe and can be done very rapidly. Thank you. stupid jerk here. Era Infinite. Sorry, I lost train of thought there. Or, not Infinite, Hawkeye win a plus. Yes, how dare you? Both of his melee guards have candy. Jeez, we're having. Having one round issues. Well, the Elf Thunder doesn't even get him. That's yikes. Well, solution just crit, apparently. Souling at full health, huh? Real big brain play. Okay. Tux. From the 30 strength, that's pretty good for the levels he gets now. All right, be right back again. Ran out of tissue. All right, let's do this. Yeah, let's swap Morgan over to Axebreaker. We're at a point where we've got so many max stats that it's like, it's kind of not worth it. mind or magic is kind of suffering. So I might try to grab that spirit dust, what the thief looted, and then beat the crap out of him. I wonder if we're gonna miss any benchmarks because of... this. Well, we're definitely fine against the heroes. Yay, a magic. Feels like that took ages. Well, that was a really easy longbow clean up there. It's like Exilus's goons decided to be extra annoying. So now we don't have to worry about these generals being behind us too much. So we got rid of their only one canter one. So Morgan can concentrate on fighting these guys here. Don't really have anywhere to go with that Gale Force aside from into the middle of the enemy. Although, let's see, there's no little plus. So we could go in and use our bow, but then I think that would aggro Exilus towards Morgan, so I'd rather wait until we take out Exilus before we start doing that. Speaking of which, here's our spirit dust. Oh, at this rate, we might not even need to use that spirit dust. Which, of course, the game would suddenly start conveniently moving after I went through all that trouble. just a few more here. And magic for Morgan, because why not, I guess. Silly will hurt. Canter is for people who actually attack at one range. Say goodbye to your healers, Wolhart. That was a pretty beefy crit considering it went into Pavis. Or I guess Aegis in that case. Well, sit down, Walhart. You're dead. And I can't believe it took until chapter 20, like halfway through it, to get our magic back up to like a decent usable level. Or at least I guess a decent reliable level. It's technically be still useful, but the it falls short by a little bit for damage, and Kron's being lazy. It gets a little spooky.
you with.
Ace will Draco shield up Morgan. Seems like a fairly straightforward approach. A little bit of a clog at the start and the end as far as counter spam. Overall, it's fairly light. Aegis Plus on Elgol's a little bit annoying. Means I'll have to be a little more careful on the turn where trying to get him, because we may miss a kill even with Bolganon. Chrom has to do things. You know Chrom. Oops, I guess Lucina's not fast enough here. Missing it by 2 points. Yeah, that slightly complicates things. Only slightly. Really, Morgan can technically just ignore that Berserker, thanks to Axebreaker. In fact, I think it's potentially actually kind of useful because it lets him springboard. Guess we'll see here. Well, we got a little bit of distance. Not the best movement, but whatever. Oof, we missed the kill on him. I see. Yay, we got res. Astonishingly. Also, I like how we straddle that fine line where we can double the assassins but not the swordmasters with Lucina. That's kind of silly. Okay, I guess we kanked him easily enough still. I guess that's what happens when you're a weird berserker dude trying to pretend you're a mage with a bolt axe. You just get destroyed by the real mages. Speedwing says no more problems for Lucina.
What can I fix you with?
Almost forgot to get the extra rescue saves. Wouldn't that have been a tragedy? Especially since we used more than usual for this run. Thank you. Right side feels like it's not geared towards taking on magic at all. Which is convenient for me. Nice. I didn't grab a beast killer, that's why. Well, then I guess Morgan's just gonna go, well, Silver Axe destroys you. Yeah, there's our A-axes. Now we can use the Hellswath we're about to steal. Nice, that was... very low damage. I guess even with an armor slayer, Must is supposed to be a massive tank, still. Thank you. That definitely felt better than anything I was about to do with Robin. Okay, dead lords successfully mugged. Buy stuff. Lucina might still be able to get to A swords for Grima. No A rank weapon for Lucina though. Bit of a bummer. Alright, gonna refill my drink one more time, and that should be the final stretch, so I'll be right back. Alright, let's go. You. Alright, well, pass on that guy means Morgan's gonna have to deal with him. So now it's that I missed giving Lucina a strength tonic. It's weird. Yeah, it was all written, blah blah blah. Backline's got a lot of canter. We can still probably get pretty aggressive about this, so. A Tonebreaker going around. Thank you. Alright, Lucille just ether and not allow him to do anything. I shouldn't have any crit ray listed, so... Morgan shouldn't take more than maybe 40 damage total. That works. I'm not quite getting rest of resistance setups here, so attacking these guys is a little janky. You know, after I was praising Chrome about getting good strength before, he suddenly just, like, dropped off the face of the planet in that regard. Thank you. last wave of reinforcements. I don't like this clump here. That's kind of annoying. Even though I can defuse it fairly easily with what I've got. They could also disperse themselves. Still quite a bit of candy to go around, especially since the reinforcements added three more. That crit. Alright, well, that takes care of that. So now we have to pick on poor Validar, because in his infinite wisdom, he decided not to bring Hawkeye. So rip his face. slow arrivals with Basilio. Nice. Well, that is kind of yikes. We just steamrolled him. Crit, dual strike, crit. Like, I usually don't even get results like that when I equip Valflame. Never mind, this is a random Arc Thunder. Yeah, I guess I have that goddess icon just sitting around from when I whacked Aversa. Silica's forged. Yeah, despite all that density of candor in 23, I didn't actually need to use that much for rescue. Man, they really want me to use a bunch of Celicas there. Oh, that bodes well. From whipping that attack. Hey, Krom finally got another point of strength. I'm gonna keep Libra here to try to keep them from going too far up north from Morgan. We've had a little bit of problem with drift from the enemy that way in the past. Practically a one-shot, 73 damage, yikes. Seems it's all, or I guess not all, but a lot of it's concentrated in the middle. Mid left for it doesn't do anything until next turn. Jeez, that was way closer than it should have been. Rom, you slacker. I like how Lucina didn't dual strike, because it's like she was waiting to make that dual guard instead. Me get surrounded before I get to do anything about this Hawkeye guy. But if he's the only one who's constantly hitting Morgan, we'll end up mostly healing it off anyway, so whatever. We've thinned the crowd pretty hard already. Wait, is this guy heading south? Did half of the boss or a third of the boss pack get distracted by Morgan? Seemingly no reason. Well, apparently the game's just completely drunk or something. I've never seen a boss pack break up like that. Just gotta take care of that stuff. I like how long it took this great knight to get through the forest to him too. It really makes me question the pathfinding involved. Like, what part of the Awakening's decision tree made it decide to take 5 turns to get through the stupid woods to get to Morgan? Survived. Boo. Also, Morgan with the completely capped stats. Yo. Thank you. Man, I think my neighbors are suplexing boulders upstairs again. I don't know if you can all hear that coming through the mic, but it's thunk 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 thunk. First brought Aegis, just the sandbag even more. Actually, that does remind me. Could Chrom have an additional hit? Gasp! Really, Robin was a more enticing target. Okay, if you say so. Whack. Yeah, I guess Chrom suffering from the syndrome Robin was at the start. Except instead of magic, it's no more strength, never gain it again. Okay, what skill? Strength or chrome? Deflux, speed, skill, magic, hit points. Deflux, skill, strength. Deflux, speed, skill, strength, hit points. Not reorder. Actually, swap. Alright, we should be good to go. Let's put an end to this. Nice. Get to weed in with some vengeance. How often do you get to hear that too? It's like, yay, I got hit in the face. I guess I didn't rally with Chrom, but it wouldn't have mattered too much. Her vengeances weren't big enough. Although I guess Chrom could have crit. Usually he has a very small chance to crit, and it's occasionally happened. GG. Well, that was long. It's good as we could have expected from the start that happened, though. Especially with, I don't know how long we were stuck at 8 magic, but that was really bad. And then being betrayed by the rescue staff. But hey, close it out. We got a win for gender swap Chrom. Although it was most definitely a cursed win, so... I don't know if Ken will be satisfied or not. I think for the moment, I definitely am gonna just keep going back to reconvoying any of the trade swaps. It's a little annoying, but it also feels a little bit better in terms of just not setting myself up to possibly accidentally miss menu into doing something stupid. I think I need to start following my notes a little more closely again. It's because a number of those memorization points have faded. And I think I'm wasting as much time, if not more, trying to remember off the top of my head compared to just scrolling through again. I'm sure once I've done it a couple times with my notes again, and like full times with my notes, it'll all be largely committed back to memory. Also, still can't believe Chapter 4 is as much of a struggle as it was. Like, for this iteration, I almost want to say it was... more brutal than most of the Gauntlet? I think Chapter 6 did a, or made a pretty good effort to match it. We just happened to be able to squeak by. Mind if the rescue staff hadn't betrayed us in Chapter 5, Chapter 6's setup would have been a fair bit more manageable. But then I guess we would have had more problems in Chapter 11 with less rescue uses remaining. Ugh. That magic was truly atrocious. It's chronically missing benchmarks is just not great, and that it somehow managed to be that from Chapter 5 onward for almost the entire time that having a set amount of magic mattered. This run somehow still finished. Suppose in the end, she couldn't help everywhere, but what's what makes a surprisingly good backup strat? And really, is preferable to Muriel as a partner once we're past that part where Wissa would need to be doing rescue work. Actually, another place I should be considering the swap is Paralog 3. Because occasionally, outside of stupid things like this, we still fail to meet the benchmarks by just a little bit. The list is deployed anyway, and as is, she often doesn't really need to do any healing. So at the cost of... I guess it'd be probably close to 15 avoid at that point. For swapping her in place of Crom. Cost of that and taking away a little bit of experience from Crom. If the counter melee is looking really spammy there, I should really consider swapping Wissa to the pair partner temporarily for the magic boost. I think if it'd be really viable to consider it for chapter 11 too. I think for the most part, probably not, but I think if we reach a point like this again, where even with the forged L-Thunder, we're missing the benchmarks. Maybe I need to find a backup that does do that. We were really close to getting cornered. And we did end up taking quite a bit of damage, despite having high D, so I don't know. I don't know what I'd really consider in terms of the map being bad enough for me to go for that. It's like if Chrom durability isn't good enough, or I guess it's seemingly borderline good enough, then we might get ourselves into serious trouble with Lissa. Anyway, it is early, so speaking of Lissa.
Chrom, we have to do something.
What do you propose we do?
I don't know.
I see you're awake now.
Hey there.
There are better places to take a nap than on the ground, you know. Give me your hand. Welcome back. It's over now.
All right, so that's definitely it for tonight/ this morning. We'll be back on Sunday. We're going to be moving Mystery Dungeon there. I'm still considering whether I want to do 2 days of it. I'm still leaning towards yes. Especially since I still need to mess around and test the Dazzle again. But we'll see how I feel. I'm going to try to get it figured out this weekend. I guess no promises, since I'm probably going to be out for a while after finishing this, but we'll see. Sunday's Mystery Dungeon. Wednesday will be either Mystery Dungeon or Halo. Friday, we're going to try to do some more attempts. Due to some complications with work, I might actually have to do something really early in the morning like this upcoming Friday. So if that does happen, I'm going to try anyway, but if it takes too much out of me, I might need to figure something else out. That's what we're working at for the week. So thanks for watching, everyone. Hope to see you Sunday, and have yourselves a good night.